Hello, 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 everybody. Finally playing my first game that has a camera, which is fun. I'm excited to finally get this going. Let's see. Okay. Getting all my stream manager set up, giving people time to join. Okay. So my plan today is to kill off everybody except for Caitlyn. So this is going to be the final girl kind of ending. So I do not want the death rewind feature on because I'm planning on killing everybody. The first thing, I just need to start from chapter 4. I know this is a weird way to do that. Oh shoot. Let's see, chapter select. Actually, let's just start a new game, actually. This is what I would like to do. Let's start from the beginning. And yeah. The goal here is to kill everybody except for Caitlyn. Ooh, I need to pause this. I need to change in the settings real quick to the alternative music just for copyright issues. There we go. Okay, here we go. So this will be probably like my fourth or fifth time playing the Quarry. I really like this game. I've played a lot of different endings. And yeah, I'm excited to play this one specifically. I'm trophy hunting a bit. And really, really would like that Trophy Hunter, the final girl playthrough. Yeah, the intro's incredibly long, but at least we were able to change the music. The other day they announced that the Quarry cast are going to get together and play the game, which is actually pretty cool. But yeah, for now you get to watch me play the game.
Why'd you kill the music?
I think you know why.
I don't think I do.
It begins with an L? Like the L word?
Oh, I love
lesbians.
That show.
Lost,
see, exactly.
Max, we're lost.
We're in geographic flux.
Right, so lost.
That's
who
the band.
Says geographic flux? Just admit.
Oh, heads up. Yeah, honey, nice catch.
I guess
Thank
I could have
you?
Totally just missed it and wouldn't
yeah,
have
the roads
anything.
Are definitely getting worse out here.
I guess it's all part of the rustic summer camp experience.
Oh, right, that's where we're going. I lost track like 200 miles ago.
200 miles ago, huh?
Yeah. You know what, Max, it's okay. It doesn't make you any less of a man.
You know, if Columbus hadn't gotten lost and landed on these golden shores, there would be no United States of America.
Goodbye, not
hot
true.
Dogs. See you later, apple pie.
Columbus never actually landed in North America.
Yeah.
What are you talking about?
Didn't even know he wasn't in Asia.
Are you serious?
Just another guy who didn't want to admit he was
yeah.
lost.
Well, just another guy
Definitely.
Who's got a whole day named after him, so put that
The
in
funny thing is, one of the first times I've played this was literally on Columbus Day. And I was like,
working on it.
Oh, Mark. Cool. That's the day. I guess I'll pick up the map and actually help.
Voila!
What is that?
Yeah.
No, but seriously, how will happen to the normal map?
This is the normal map?
The one on the phone.
No bars.
Oh my god, how much of a teenager are they?
Of course not.
The normal map is the phone one?
Okay, let's see. So we are... Well, I guess they don't put summer camps on maps. Have you seen any signs for it?
Dude, he's not looking at the road at all.
Eyes on the road!
Whoa!
Yeah, see, this is what happens.
Max!
Totally saw that ghost. I don't know if you did. I wonder if I didn't miss that, like, whether or not, like, it would just crash the car or something like that, and then you can't recover it or something. I don't know. Who knows? I feel like there's so many things about this game, even though I've played it a lot of times, that I still don't know.
Yeah. I mean, still in one piece.
Jesus Christ, what do you think that was? A bear?
What? No, Max, it wasn't a bear.
What was it?
I think it was a person.
Why do they... They or always think it's a bear.
Do you think we hit a person?
I don't know. I mean, it was really close, like, really close, but maybe we didn't... What is it?
I really effed this car up.
Oof.
Well, maybe it looks worse than it is?
I should check out the damage before we try to start it up again, huh? Could you grab my, the toolbox from the trunk?
Yeah, okay.
Yay, the first time I get to walk around. I think I'm just gonna do the more fun run-through where I just do the wrong things.
It's not so bad.
My mom's gonna kill me.
Whereas, like, he needed the tools, so, like, I definitely will try to take some time before getting those tools and do it when he wants. Ooh, hell yeah, I'm gonna snoop. Okay, I don't know if this is, like, a thing it says... for graduate schools, we encourage you to apply to other graduate schools, and we wish you every success with your studies and beyond. But I'm pretty sure they're supposed to be like high schoolers applying for just undergrad. Like, graduate school would be if he was getting his master's, right?
Thanks, hon.
Like, maybe that's just a plot point that I missed, or maybe are like in their 20s and not teenagers, but I'm pretty sure it should be undergrad.
Perfect, thank you.
The sooner we get out of here, the better.
Just picture yourself curling up in front of a big old fire pit singing campfire sing-alongs.
I don't think people curl up right in front of big old fire pits.
Why not?
They don't want to catch on fire.
Then picture yourself curling up in front of a big old space heater.
Well, anywhere's better than here.
Well, that's nice. Let's just walk off. Immediately. They won't even let me. Ugh. That's disappointing. Oh, there's more stuff to look at? Oh, no, I already did this. I don't want to do that again. Ugh. Okay, yeah, okay, I got it. Yes. Mm-hmm. I've already read that. The red lights, though. Pretty ominous. Seems I am just kind of stuck over here. What was it? I thought I was supposed to walk off this way. Or maybe I walk off that way? What am I... Oh, I need to bring in the tools? What? I'm really confused. Oh. Okay. That's on me.
Where are you going?
Just over here.
Yeah, where are you going?
Stay there for a second,
woods,
okay? I'm almost done.
In the middle of the night. I'm gonna be rude.
What? You're not the boss of me.
I just don't want you wandering off on your own.
Excuse me.
That's not what I meant.
Yeah, it better not be.
I'm sorry. I really gotta concentrate
just,
for
like,
a second.
Worried.
Okay?
Yes.
My gosh. Like,
look,
he's
I think there's
the
someone
car,
down there, okay?
And what's all that? She does is like, I need to go.
You could be hurt.
Wander into the forest.
I'm gonna go check it out. Good idea, Laura. So thoughtful of you.
She just immediately slips. Oh, that seemed kind of like a letdown. It's like super dramatic, and then all of a sudden it's just like, oh, there she is. Ooh, the fool. I don't know if I'm gonna investigate like every single clue in here because my main goal is just to, you know, get to the end. And I don't really need every single clue to do that. I don't plan on 100%ing the game. And getting all the clues and evidence just like ever, because it's pretty complicated to do, actually. Ooh, I found a box, though. That's concerning. Oh, escapeology, okay. Like a Houdini. I guess this is the right way to go. That's a pretty good one. Not so much a jump scare, but like clearly that there's something out there. What do you want? In case you don't know, I am actually in charge of the light on the controller. So, or I'm in charge of the light on the phone, and I get to move it with my controller. So that'll show me kind of things in the dark and, well, do what a flashlight does. She's just, like, so lost. Like, what was the point of coming out into the forest to help someone if now you're just completely helpless? Like, logic, she's got none.
Where are you?
Silence.
Oh. Just whisper in her ear. Could she just like die here if I let her get hit by that? Like, what happens? I'm not gonna do it. Let's just see. Because she's out running a goat. Oh, I hear that like crow though.
Max? Max?
Oh shoot.
Max!
Hey, why are you shouting? What?
Dude, she's like losing it. There was definitely someone behind him.
Car. Now. Yeah. Now.
Okay.
Did you see it?
No, but I heard something. Let's just get out of here.
At least they're not like everyone else that is like, I'm extremely scared. Let's go find the thing.
Honey, I know you're on edge, but you gotta calm down, okay?
I am not on edge, Max. I'm freaking the fuck out.
It was probably just an animal or
something. No, it wasn't an animal. You didn't see it. It was a woman.
Lord, this isn't helping, all right? Go. There we go. We're good. See?
Please just get us out of here.
Okay.
Max!
I'm trying.
Dude, he is struggling. I don't know about trying. He's just making it worse.
We're safe in the car, really. We're gonna be okay.
Jeez!
Oh, fuck! Oh, my God. My heart just exploded.
He just gives off immediately just, like, sketch vibes.
Hi, officer. How are you doing this evening?
Are either of you injured?
No. Well, she bumped her head.
Well, barely bumped it. I mean, I can't even feel it. My bump, not my head. I'm fine.
Really, we're fine.
Oh wow, such a good liar. Is he just trying to like look at our car for us?
Well, you folks want to tell me what happened here?
What? Clearly, it was an accident, bro. Yeah, I'm just gonna be evasive. Oh my God,
well,
those shifty
we were
eyes.
Just driving, and it's really, really dark out here. And I don't know. We must have hit like a pothole or something, because we swerved, and now here we are.
Yeah, he's not gonna like that.
I mean, these roads are really not in great shape.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sir?
Yeah, of course he doesn't believe me.
Car running. Sir?
Is this kind of like the all-time scariest cop?
Yeah, pretty much.
This is my first cop.
What, like ever?
Yeah, I'm not a criminal.
Well, yeah, aren't they high schoolers?
Folks want to tell me just what in the hell you are doing all the way out here this late at night.
Why is he so mad at me? Are we not allowed to drive? My God. Yeah,
we were just
if he's gonna be a dick to me,
officer.
Might as well be a dick
crime?
To him.
Ma'am, I'm gonna take it by the tone of your voice that you were unaware that this is an open season hunting zone until tomorrow.
Shit.
Yikes.
No, didn't know that. We were kind of lost, actually.
What is your intended destination?
We're headed up to Hackett's Quarry.
Not the camp.
It's a free place to stay, so, yeah.
Oh, he doesn't like my tone.
We're
just saying,
make it to Hackett's Quarry.
It's a free place to stay. Like,
not
who would
want
to pay for a place to stay when you could stay someplace for free?
Harbinger Motel. It's the nearest place. You can bunk up there for the night, okay?
I think we're just gonna stick to the plan, sir. I mean, Mr. Hackett knows we're coming and we called ahead.
No, ma'am. You're gonna head to the Harbinger Motel. Do you understand?
Dude, that, like, dead... that dead stare. I'm gonna be... insistent, like, dude, why not?
All due respect, sir, why can't we go to Hackett's Quarry?
Because I told you to go to the motel.
Like, if he could have just explained, like,
okay,
oh,
I just don't understand what
you know,
ma'am,
like, he's not gonna be there.
What? Why?
Officer, she
I know
anything.
Him. Like, he won't be there, you know?
Ma'am,
just say something.
If you
that's not gonna be like,
out of the vehicle,
just no, because
just
I
like
said
to
show
so. Show you a route on your map there.
It's like, don't you know teenagers don't like listening to authority?
For sure.
Son? Remain in the vehicle.
It's okay.
Why do I have to get out of the car for him to look at my map? I and put it on, like, a dirty hood. It's gonna ruin the map.
So, we...
Ew, he just, like, licks my pencil.
All right, about here. Harbinger Motel is here.
Right, okay, and where was Hackett's Quarry again?
Ooh, he was about to put it on there.
I'm sure the fine folks at the Harbinger Motel can guide you there first thing in the morning.
I love how his subtitles are red. Like, they're not even trying to be subtle about it. It's like, maybe you should like this guy? It's just like, he gives off bad vibes.
Still, please.
Hold still.
What are you doing?
What is he doing?
Hold still.
I'm just gonna hold still because I'm really curious what the hell's about to happen. I don't know if I've ever had that before. Mm-hmm. What the hell?
Fresh as a daisy.
That was so weird. Like, what? What? Like, I could have done that myself. I didn't need some random cop to do that for me. It's not like he did that to Max.
Harbinger Motel. Stay on the road.
But, like, isn't the definition of Harbinger, like, bad? Like, it brings bad things, right? Like, why would I want to go to a place called... Why would they name something that?
Why is this guy just sitting there?
I mean, yeah, no, that guy was definitely weird.
Giving me major weirdo vibes.
The dude needed, like, at least a dozen showers.
Oh my god, I know.
What was up with the thing? Did you see that?
Was it blood?
Yeah, they're just, like, low-key, just nice very chill, like, oh yeah, he had blood all over him, right? Like, that was cool.
All right, let's get back on the road.
Yes.
I think I've had enough woodland encounters for one night. Thank you very much.
Agreed. So where's this motel?
Okay, so we're here,
mm-hmm.
and the motel is here.
Okay.
But we're going here.
What's there?
Hackett's Quarry.
Of course. They don't listen.
I don't know. I kind of tricked them into showing me.
Very slick.
I mean, yeah.
Are you sure we shouldn't just get to the motel and just listen to this guy's advice?
Honey, you told us in the middle of the creep-ass woods to go to some creep-ass hotel.
No, that sounds terrible. Yeah. Let's hit the road,
yeah.
Shall we?
No, that was pretty creepy. I would not have listened to him either.
Oh my god, if he called me ma'am one more time, I was going to shove that badge up his dick. Seriously, do I look like a ma'am to you? I got like 20 years before I'm a ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
20 years? Yeah, what? No.
20's... debatable.
Yeah, I agree.
I mean, I'm kind of into ma'ams.
I'm in my 20s and people already call me ma'am, unfortunately, and I hate it. Just because I don't want to be considered a ma'am.
You gotta be kidding me. There's nobody here. We drive all the way the fuck out
Max,
here.
Max, can we just look around before we jump to conclusions?
Did you actually even talk to Mr. Hackett or did you just leave a message?
Well, what's the difference?
This is the difference.
There is a huge difference. She's dumb.
Hello?
I guess he doesn't check his voicemail.
How was I supposed to know that? I mean, clearly there's somebody here.
Yeah, or it's just an abandoned car and this is a complete waste
Why
of time.
Why would there be an abandoned...
I'll get the car.
Max, come on. Max, don't be a dick.
I'm sorry.
He's just sorry? Like, he's not even gonna try?
Is anybody home?
I I guess might as well try. But yeah, nothing's gonna happen. Yeah, of course it won't. Ooh. I love how they just have like a light shining in the back. Like, Loki, look at this. Let's go check it out. What's that? A storm cellar? She's just peeping in. Like, I don't think that's my immediate thing.
When
I see a storm cellar, you're not just like, is that someone down there that needs help?
I'll be right back. I'm gonna get some help.
Why do they need help?
Max! Max, get over here!
What's going on?
There's somebody in the bunker. I think they might be stuck.
Stuck? Is it Mr. Hackett?
What makes you assume these things?
Bring some tools so we can break the lock.
Hey,
so back.
Many assumptions.
We're gonna get you out of there.
Hey.
Wait, what are these?
I don't know, you just said tools.
Why didn't you just bring... Look, there's someone in there.
What, did he have bolt cutters in there? Like, what?
I'm not seeing anyone.
What? No, look.
I'm looking, I am.
Let me see.
It's like you'd only be able to see it if you were, like, right in front of the door. Let's take wrenches. That seems more fun.
You sure?
Yeah. I'm sure.
Saw it online.
Yeah, sure, yeah. What?
Damn.
What? I just don't even understand what that was.
You need a hand?
You just stick wrenches in there and they're like, ah, it pops off. You don't need a key.
You've seen the Evil Dead, right?
I have not, actually.
Hello?
But I have a feeling I know what he means by this.
Are you hurt?
Do you exist?
I mean, that tire's moving. And it's just slowing down now.
Be careful.
So clearly someone's here. Someone touched that. Where's that bicycle tire? There it is.
I'm just... You know, I'm scoping it out.
Scoping it out? Like, there's no reason you should be here. You just broke a lock on something. Can we just leave? I don't want to be here. No. Okay. That's not an option. And no! Is that like... It looks like it's almost scribbled, like, words, but not really. Go look at that. Just like a carcass. You don't question that at all. Like,
Max?
I would just immediately run. Like, immediate nope. This bitch is crazy. Like, she sees that and just, like, calmly standing there right next to it now. Yeah, no, I'm out of here. I'm not keep going down.
Hun, maybe it was a possum or something.
No, there was someone here, I swear.
Was it that bear?
It's been kind of a night, you know? Let's
Hi,
just get to the motel.
To
we can come back here first thing in the morning. We can check everything out, but... I mean, you must be exhausted. I know I am. I think our imagination...
Oh... time. Max? Well, at least we have the camera to capture, like, the jump scares. Max. So that's fun. Aw, shit.
Max!
His blood.
I'm gonna... Oh, dear.
I think I'm bleeding a lot.
I don't know if I'm gonna save him or if I'm just gonna run. Let's just run. Oh man, he's gonna hate me. There we go. And we're off. Immediately gets drugged. It's like, that probably wasn't the right choice.
Does this look like the goddamn Harbinger Motel to you?
Damn, he's so pissed. Every little move, he's like, why can't you have just listened to me for once? Is it sleight of hand that the music in here is very interesting, to say the least. I do love that just full moon though. It's pretty huge, pretty epic. Also just got a moon tattoo, so I could be biased. Ooh, the magician. Okay, let's keep going. I do like the tarot lady. That's a fun aspect of this game, but I do also kind of miss the like if they had flowcharts, kind of like Detroit. Friend. I love that.
Welcome to the show.
I just like seeing who chooses what,
we are
like
friends,
the percentages.
Aren't we? I've waited for you. I've waited.
Okay, yes. I don't know if anyone else has watched Seinfeld here,
together,
but if you guys have watched Seinfeld, that is Susan's mom.
No need to worry.
It threw me because the first few times, like, I felt like I recognized her, and I was just staring at her.
It's exciting. Yes.
Over and over again. And who is she? And I'm like, it's Susan's mom.
If you're brave enough, if you let
me. She's also in, like, Twin Peaks, too.
I can help.
I'm more of a Seinfeld person.
We can help each other.
We can help each other.
This is the card you found. The Fool. I wonder who this is. We all know a fool when we see one, don't we?
I mean, yeah.
Innocence and freedom. Or recklessness and risk-taking. Spontaneity. Actions without thought. The consequences to match. Think, and don't get burnt. I can show you more.
Don't
if
get
like
burnt.
To.
That's pretty funny. So what this? If you've never played this game before, you find little tarot cards, and they'll
possible future.
A hint to what would be a possible future that could happen. So yeah, and it was just saying,
there
like, don't get burned,
there,
and then, you know,
secrets
if I choose
lies,
that, then a fire could happen.
Paths to uncover, on which I can shed light,
if you let me.
Help me help you. And remember, What doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
Oh, that's funny. That's like the camp's like slogan, like the summer camp. It says, what doesn't kill you will make you stronger. Which I think is just a like nod to the whole, you know, mystery. No spoilers. What a transition. Just like, I feel like this is just peppy YouTuber music. Summer camp forever.
Peace and love.
See you later, kids.
Yeah, Hackett's Quarry forever.
Ooh. Setting up all the kids. She's like legit wearing a turtleneck sweater.
The last day of summer camp? It's like a romantic summer. Apocalypse.
Right, like that seems like a bit too much, right? And they'll get over it.
Yeah, well, I mean, they're just kids. You know, they'll get over it.
Uh-huh. Like they'll get over Emma.
Ooh,
that's not the same thing.
Oh, so that's not why you're in a bad mood.
I'm not in a bad... Oh my. You know what? We had our last night together, and we're cool.
Oh, yeah. So cool that you're never going to see your special little boo-boo bear ever again.
Jeez, Chris, you heard that?
Oh, come on, dude. The cabin walls are made of Band-Aids and rat turds.
Okay, I get it.
So that is Caitlin, our first introduction to who will be the final girl in this playthrough.
Hey.
Okay, this is, you've heard of spatial awareness before, right?
Yeah, spatial awareness is for nerds. Beat a lamb and grab the last couple of bags, will ya?
Yes, boss.
Say hi to Emma for me.
You're a bad person.
Yes, I am.
I'm gonna go say hi to Ryan. He's just chilling over here, and I know something bad just happened over here, so it's fun. He probably won't talk to me.
Some hay bales caught fire during the opening. Hey, hello. What are you listening to? Before they knew it, the whole place was up in smoke. Good to know.
Yeah, of course he doesn't talk to me. Also, I did like my first two or three playthroughs of this game without like doing the walk fast feature because I totally forgot that it even existed. Like, I guess I must have done some the tutorial super early and just forgot about it. But hopefully this will help speed up things.
Are you guys gonna help with the bags or what?
Oh, you know, I was actually just working on fixing the door. It's
Dylan, come
it's
on.
Broken.
Dylan, please.
I can't. It's
I gotta get the last bags in there. Come on.
What's wrong with this thing? It's just
Dylan,
closing.
Please.
Dylan's being such a dick.
Cool, thanks guys.
For no reason. Let's see. I guess we're gonna have to sneak in through the window.
Oh, skill.
Skill. I don't need to read books. I'm the fool, right? Jacob's supposed to be the fool. What am I going in for? Just the bags, right? Yeah, I don't want to talk to anyone else. Just like this random touching music just to pick up some bags.
All right, got the bags.
Great. All by yourself, huh?
Yep.
Guess you're gonna have to get used to that.
Oh my god, you are so mean.
At least I'm honest.
Oh, okay, yeah. Here we go.
Okay, you're not telling me the whole truth about you and Emma, are you, son?
I'm just gonna be defensive. I'm gonna be
okay,
a dick.
I'm gonna need you back all the way out of my business, Caitlin.
Well, excuse me for trying to help.
How is making me feel shitty about being dumped supposed to help?
Uh-huh, yeah, that's kind of true.
She took out the trash.
What? No.
Wait, check that. First, she cleaned the house. Then she took out the trash. Then she washed her hands. Bye-bye, Jake. Now she's a trashless single, clean hands, ready to mingle.
Are you finished?
Oh, I could go on.
No, not at all. I really hope that she finishes. No thanks.
Yeah, no thanks.
Man, you're starting to bum me out, Jake.
Well, I...
Bum me out? You're the one just, like, relentlessly making fun of me for being sad.
Okay, well, at least I went for it this summer.
What's that supposed to mean?
Ryan?
What about him? He's a guy at this camp who just happens to have this whole hot, sexy loner thing that totally doesn't do anything for me at all.
Oh, and the plot thickens.
Yeah.
So she really just dumped you just like that?
Well, technically no, but, you know, she realized that she has her plans... And, I have my plans, and it wasn't gonna work after today, you know? And today's already over, isn't it?
And you didn't want to try, like, long distance or whatever? Man, she has got you wrapped all the way around that cute little finger of hers.
Yeah, that's a little sus. Maybe I'd like it. I mean, that's interesting, but I'm gonna
say... Okay, you know what? Maybe you're right. Maybe she does have, like, this superpower over me, but you know what? Maybe I like it.
Likes it. Check. Totally not in denial.
Oh,
check.
Okay.
Ooh, that's a new one.
The fumes of jealousy are just stifling over here.
Excuse me?
I'm just saying, I guess some girls don't have what it takes to hang with the big dog.
You're a real charmer, you know that?
It's hard because it's like, since you play as all these characters throughout the story, you forget which one you're trying to root for the most. I'm gonna be encouraging.
Look, I'm just saying, I don't know why you didn't make a move on Ryan. You should have seized the moment.
Well, can't seize the moment that never happened.
Yeah, well, you can't
Does
wait
she actually
to
have
you.
A thing
you gotta
for
make
Ryan.
The moment happen yourself.
Oh, right. Chase the moment around all summer like a dog with two dicks until it dumps you on the last day of camp.
Okay. Not gonna miss
it. What a one-liner right there.
Okay, so are we sure that this old rust bucket's roadworthy?
We'll take a look. It better be. One more night in the great outdoors might actually kill me.
Hey, what doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
Well, I haven't killed you.
It's pretty good.
Yet. You're still pretty pathetic.
Hey, shut up. Okay, so, total hypothetical, but if I was like a huge asshole and I wanted to break down the van so we'd have to spend another night here, what exactly would I need to do?
Well, you'd... probably break the fuel line, or, I don't know, rip out the rotor arm.
Here's the thing.
And yes, that would make you a total asshole.
Yeah.
Okay, and what is a
Why does she answer it, though?
Look like again?
Like,
it's like an arm that's all rotary.
She gives
you know,
him
the
exact answer
the
of what to
out.
Do. Like, if I needed to break the she, car just for one night, what would I do?
Even if we somehow did get stuck out here,
and then she tells
one more
him.
Night with Emma wouldn't make a difference. Trust me, chick's made up her mind.
Yeah. Sure. Guess we'll just have to find out.
Like, I don't have an option to not break the car. So I'm gonna steal the little arm.
Come on with me, buddy.
Ooh.
I'll put you right back tomorrow. No harm, no foul.
Up here, my dudes.
My dudes.
Why did they look like they're up to something?
Hey, Jacob.
What? No, dude, please. Don't.
Along. Oh, Nick!
Oh, God. In the middle of drinking some water. Of
Boom.
Course, there's always
oh.
a when quick time events
there
happen,
it is.
Right?
Oh, ooh. Man, good sight.
Some moves.
Freak.
Oh. Oh. Ooh, I wish I had some singles.
Freaks. I'm surrounded by freaks.
Yeah, teenage boys.
Oh, thank God. I mean, I get the whole no technology thing, but take me back, world.
You would have thought Mr. H could have, like, charged up our phones, like, a little bit.
Nothing's ever your fault, is it?
You know, you should really just save it for emergencies only.
Dylan's unless, of the course, smart one out here.
Being dumped an emergency.
Oh, Ben.
Ooh, Ben. That accent, though. I'm just really not a fan of Nick. I'm just gonna be annoying.
Back off, dipshit.
I'm sorry. Peace and love, man. I
yeah, peace and love, man. Like, as if he didn't just say something incredibly hurtful.
Where's everybody else?
Why would I know that?
Mm-hmm. Sometimes you know stuff I don't.
Look, I don't even know how to respond to that.
You say, Nick, you're way smarter than me, and you're a super hot stud who gets any chick he wants.
Okay, yeah. Keep dreaming, Junior.
It's like very surprising how they all just kind of couple up too, but not surprising either. But there's just like perfect fits for everyone. When I first played this, I 100% assumed that that was her girlfriend, like, that they were a couple. Because who draws photos of another person like that, right? You would, like, just assume that they were together. And, like, she gives off kind of, you know, vibes that could lean that way, let's say. You know, like, colored hair, tattoos, like,
empty nesters.
Wearing tights with shorts. And saying, like, we're empty nesters. I'm like, oh, okay. They're a couple, right?
Oh boy. You're about to get your phone back,
but
aren't
it's
you?
Like, let's go no. collect our no, they're not.
And away
not at all.
From this mosquito-infested backwoods dump. Doors locked, bags inside.
Fuck me.
Yep.
Well, it's obvious what we have to do here.
Find someone with a key?
Shape our destiny. And by shape our destiny, I mean shape our way through this crappy lock and grab our bags.
Yeah, let's break in.
Okay, let's do it. We better not get into trouble.
I won't tell if you won't tell.
The little mini backpack with bat wings, like, that's pretty cool.
I just think it was a bear or something.
Have you ever seen a bear in these woods?
No, but that doesn't mean
they're not out there.
Fair point.
All right, let's do this. On three. One, two, three! Ugh. All about the power of positive thinking.
Why do I ever listen to you?
Because I'm always right.
I don't think I've ever
not.
Are you sure
they're gonna think it was a bear?
Oh my God, relax. It's not like we killed someone.
All right, well, I'm just gonna take another look around, make sure we didn't miss anything.
Go nuts.
Aw. This was little Izzy's.
It's so creepy, though.
I want to play a game!
Yeah, no. Unfortunately, or fortunately,
let's get you back to Izzy.
I will keep this. I remember the first time I played this, I saw that bunny, and I immediately was like, for some reason, I know I need this thing. I know it's not, like, the most important thing ever, but I feel like it's gonna help me later on. I'm not really focusing on the lore too much in this one, or, like, evidence or things like that. So I see here that there's a crow up on this thing. Or raven, crow. Crow's the right one. But, I wonder if you don't go up to it, if that just, like, ruins what's it called? Radio. If you need to use it later. I'm not really certain. Okay. I guess it's time to go. I'm not gonna do too much exploring. This is a pretty camp, though. Like, I'd go here if I was a kid. You know, and you didn't know what was actually happening. Just run right into the swing. She over here? Yeah, she's over here. Yeah, this quick walk makes such a difference. Like, can you imagine if I had to walk all that distance and it wasn't in the quick walk?
Ready to roll?
Yeah, let's go. Ooh, she looks so uncertain here.
Let's do it. Finally. Time to let loose and vamoose this caboose.
How are you so
dramatic?
Annoying.
Yeah, annoying. Confident. That's the right word.
It's just acting. It's what the people want.
So you're faking it?
I mean, in a way, faking it is just being yourself, but louder.
Well,
you should try it sometime. You know? Never know who you might impress.
Nah. It's too late now anyway.
For what? You and Nick? You never know unless you put yourself out there.
Okay, let's make sure. Don't fuck this up.
Oh, wow! Oh. Nice steering, Tex.
Jinkies.
Jinkies. Oh, okay, so she's Velma. Okay, that makes a lot of sense.
Out there, what if he ends up being a dud, kind of like you and Jacob?
He's actually really sweet.
Then why'd you quit it?
Yeah, valid.
Summer fling. We're going to school, like, 4 states away. He gets it.
Yeah, sure.
But that's us. You and Nick could be different. When you get his handle, hit him up.
Oh, I already have his email. It was in the packet they gave to us on the first day.
She's, like, so email? Insistent. She talks so fast sometimes.
What's wrong with email?
She's like, it's in the packet on the first day. She's, like, so
I'm really gonna miss
excited to know that she has his email.
Oh, hold up.
Oh, but the lodge is that way.
Go right here.
Why?
Come on, scenic route. One last victory lap around the camp.
Let's just go back to the lodge. I'm gonna be late. Really, I'm sorry. Back.
Boo. Thumbs down.
Everyone's waiting for us.
Aw, Emma
Nick
thinks I'm a party
gonna
pooper.
Leave without saying goodbye.
Shit, Abby!
Oh. I'm so glad I didn't hit that, because in one playthrough
Sorry,
I hit it.
Dude. My girl
totally
here is on her way to ask
to.
The guy out for the first time, like, ever.
Emma!
Couldn't let her squirrel out of it.
I am going to throw you out of the cart.
I deserve that.
Yeah, she does. Just like an awkward pause.
Don't worry, Jacob. I got you. I got a full tank of gas, so. Oh, fuck me.
Oh, idiot.
Does nobody own phone chargers anymore?
There's no signal out here, anyways, dude, okay? This place is like patchy as balls.
Your balls are patchy?
What? No.
Well, he's the one that said it.
I'll just go get some juice from Mr. H before we go and.
Ew.
What? Like, that's not gross. He just needs to charge his phone.
Hey, Nick.
Hey, where were you guys?
Wouldn't you like
He has, like, zero personality.
Ignore her,
he just goes,
please.
T-posing it out.
Let's
like,
go.
Hey, where were you guys? Except in an Australian accent.
Just
that's
gotta
his
get
entire
these
personality.
Bags up onto the...
Oh, hey, here. Let me get it for you.
I can take care of my own bag, thank you. What?
Are you sure? I mean, it's really not that big
she
of a deal.
She can take care of her own bag. Thank you.
We can
you.
Both take care of our own bag. Thank you.
Thank you. Like, they just sound so awful right there.
Cool.
It's like, we can both. Ugh. I mean, yeah, I'm a little bit just like, should I nudge? Oh my gosh, wait. This gets so awkward if you don't do anything. I'm just standing there like someone should help Abby. Dude. Just, like, so awkward. There's still complete silence. Like, not a single person talking.
Hey, has anyone seen Ryan?
Oh, yeah, he's probably off being all brooding and mysterious and alluring somewhere.
I'm here.
What were you doing under there? Having a little knee party?
I was listening to a podcast, actually.
Oh, podcast. Nice, that's cool.
What's it about?
I'm going to be protective of him.
I think it's called How to Mind Your Own Business. You should listen to it.
Damn.
Ghosts.
That's just, like, so rude.
Ghosts.
Yeah, well, all sorts of cryptozoology, really. The episode I was listening to was actually about this place.
Oh, yeah, yeah. The one that you were talking about to the kids at the campfire.
The Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
Yeah. Yes.
What's the Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
You don't know about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
The Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
If I did, would I be asking dumbass?
Tell her about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
I don't think she wants to know about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
Can we just please stop saying the Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
The Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
It's just this campfire story for kids. It's there's supposedly an old woman who died in a fire a few years back. She haunts the woods looking for her lost baby boy. There are, like, reports of whispers or whatever, and this.
Oh, it's definitely not whispers, I'll tell you that. Like, she was straight up going just like,
"Stop!"
right in my ear.
That if she catches you alone, she'll try to turn you into her son.
Okay.
Or kill you, or something.
Okay, that second one seems more likely. Kill you.
It's Corey.
You made that up.
It's right here in the podcast, man.
Right here in the podcast. Girl. I'm going to be supportive.
Seriously, though, you should have seen the first time he told the story to the kids at the campfire. They were scarred for life.
I mean, not for not life.
You got to be careful with this stuff, man. This shit's true.
Yeah. Dude, bullshit.
What's the holdup, Hacketeers?
Nearly done, Mr. H.
Well, hop to it. Get those butts in gear.
Sorry, Mr. H.
We had to liberate some luggage.
Shut up! Maybe if somebody didn't spend so much time trying to press the ladies with all his ghost stories.
You asked.
Ghost stories?
Yeah.
The Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
Oh!
Hey, you still have the van key, Mr. H?
Well, yes, I do. You know, I'd lose my head if it wasn't stuck on. Back to the office I go.
Back to the office I go. Like, he came out here
Give
for,
me
like,
hand,
10
would you,
seconds.
Ryan?
Oh, okay.
Yo, Mr. H.
What's up, DJ Dylan?
Any chance I could get a little charge? I want to have some tunes for the road.
No can do.
Just, like, why, though? I just don't understand
cool,
it.
Cool, yeah. No worries.
He's just like, Good nope, man. You're not allowed to charge your phone at all.
No big deal. You can share my earbuds.
Ooh. Okay, I've never chosen that option just because it was always like, why not? Because that's pretty annoying. It's like, if we're not leaving yet, why can't I just charge it?
So,
it's just like, no.
Chris, I'm actually glad we got a moment to talk.
I'm not fired, am I?
No, it's just, you know, about the whole thing with the...
Hold that thought, partner. I'm gonna have to take this.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Oh, sorry.
Just standing there.
Hello.
I definitely, like, want to listen in. But I think I'm gonna listen to the podcast just because I've never done that. So I wonder if it's like he just doesn't have any information then.
I'm sorry, but you're the one trying to make it about ghosts and shit.
Just fades out.
Sorry about that, bud. Sorry about that, bud.
Has it ever
Didn't mean to
see?
Push
you I was
out
giving
like
you
that.
Your privacy. That's pretty interesting that you just don't hear anything.
You need a hand looking for the keys?
No, end of summer, busy, you know. Anyway, you were asking me?
Oh, yeah, it was just the whole animation school thing, what you thought I should do.
Oh, let's go to animation school.
You know,
that's cool.
Whether or not I should, like, leave my sister with my grandparents, since I'd have to live on campus, you know. My mom's not exactly around, so I wouldn't want to leave Sarah on her own.
Like, that's a pretty serious
small enough as
question to ask.
Family is important, Ryan. Dang it.
Like, he didn't even help at all. He just goes, family is important. I'm just going to be frustrated.
This is just important to me.
You know what's important to me,
it's a
Ryan?
Huge life choice.
Trying to run a successful summer camp. Still trying to make up for the losses from last year. Terrified
what?
Kids are bad for business. Phone calls I get from scandalized parents.
Scandalized.
Nightmares, thumb-sucking, bedwetting. Think about that the next time you're flipping some yarn about the
Hagar Hackett's.
Just think next time, champ. Use the old skull muscle.
The skull muscle? I haven't heard of that one. I'm gonna be a bitch.
Yeah, it was just a fun story that weirdo kid told me last month.
Hey, that weirdo kid?
There's no weirdo here.
Damn.
At Hackett's Quarry, everyone's their own brand of cool. You counselors gotta be the responsible ones. Keep the kids happy. Keep the kids safe. So knock it off.
Yeah, we gotta keep them safe.
I mean,
I think there's no more kids here.
We are. Seriously, Chris, what's going on?
I just want to get you guys safely out of Dodge before the sun goes down.
Is that really it? Why?
Why?
It's getting dark, Ryan, and it's not safe to drive in the dark. And
okay.
Safety is the first step towards fun.
Yeah, he sounds real convincing.
Just give me a minute. Where in the good goddamn are they?
Will you say goodbye to Caleb and Kaylee for me? They sort of just snuck off.
Well, you'll see him again next year. Caleb works at the scrapyard during the off-season, and Kaylee...
Oh, I worked at the scrapyard.
Well, she's still figuring out what she wants to do. She's got her whole life ahead of her. They both just come and go as they please, really. Teenagers, am I right?
The photo looks like so photoshopped.
Actually,
could have
used the help packing up since we were short-staffed.
Hey, you guys seem to manage all right. But I'll tell them both you were sad you missed them. Unlocked the van... Put the keys in my pocket, came in the office. Right where I left them. Let's skedaddle.
Who puts keys in a coffee mug? Like, how scatterbrained do you have to be? I wish there were more, like, chapter breakups, because, like, we're still just in chapter
Make sure
one,
they're all ready
but we've
to go.
Switched between so For many characters stuff. Already.
Wait, how did you get your phone back before the rest of us?
I never turned it in.
You sure to turn it off before you handed it in, Dylan. Them's the rules, you noob.
You noob? Oh my god.
I try not to dwell on the past, man.
Good. Because it's time to dwell on the minivan. Get on with our respective lives.
Like,
Move
I feel
it.
Like
go.
Chris thinks he's, like, cool. He wants to be cool, hang around kids all the time. He's saying
What's
cool things, I guess.
Dude, I don't know. I think there's something wrong with the engine, Mr.
Or
he
thinks he is,
yeah,
at least.
I see that.
Yeah, dude, it's just, like, kaput.
All right, let me try.
What? Dude, I'm telling you, all right, it's busted.
Well, maybe you're doing it wrong.
Well, maybe you're doing it wrong.
What the fuck, dude?
Enough.
He just
both
gets, like,
you.
So weird. Jacob's like, oh.
Shit. Come on.
I don't know what to do.
Chill. Chill, dude. I'm... God.
Damn it! I thought I told you kids to check everything.
We did. It should be working.
Yeah.
Then
well,
why'd you tell them about the rotor arm?
Doesn't mean it is. Does it?
Shit, my bad.
Damn it! Okay. Okay.
Look, it's not that big of a deal, okay? We'll just
spend
one more night.
Freaking
no!
Out.
No! Just stop. Let me think.
That's a normal reaction.
Okay. Damn it. You're right, yeah.
What?
Yeah, Ryan gets it. Just, what? Oh, God. Hands on the controller. It's like I put my hands up to just go, what? And then there's a QuakeTime event.
Hey, Ryan. Come here for a sec. Make sure that everybody is inside the lodge for tonight. Lock the doors. No one in, no one out. No one. Got it?
Okay. Sure.
I'll be back first thing in the morning, and we'll get you all on the road. You just have to keep everyone inside. Can you promise me you'll do that?
That's like a huge thing to ask someone. Like, keeping all the teenagers inside. I'm gonna be uncertain.
Wait, we have to stay inside until tomorrow? Why? Where are you going?
Yeah, Ryan, like, it's still daylight out.
Trust me. Like, I'm trusting you. Can you do that? Lock
no.
the doors. And for God's sake, keep the noise down.
So, what was that about?
He, said to stay inside, that we're not leaving until the morning.
Are you kidding me?
Am.
He's so excited for like
me?
One last
what
night
are we
together.
Supposed to do?
Well, we should go inside like he said.
We could go inside until morning.
Yeah.
Or we could do something else.
Curious.
What are you talking about?
No Mr. Hackett, no screaming kids. Just a bunch of grown-ass adults ready to cut loose and get down with their animal side.
Oh, hell yeah!
Or like, what is even that supposed to mean? Get in touch with their animal side?
Why the fuck not? Alright, it seems like the stars have aligned for us, no?
Okay.
One last epic bonfire blowout for
all
time.
Oh, is that what animals do? They do bonfires?
Oh, dude. Fuck yes, I'm in, Nick. You're in.
Yeah, I'm in.
Dylan's in, obviously. My man. Caitlin?
I go where my people need me.
Yeah, okay. Em, what do you say?
Yeah, I'm in.
Yeah, I'm in.
Mr. Hackett seemed pretty insistent. Oh,
yeah,
the
nerd.
He was just trying to freak us out, you know? Like one of Ryan's stupid ghost stories.
Why would he want to scare us?
She just is like dead silent. Let's just be supportive.
I'm sure he's just looking out for us. No big deal.
Yeah, no big deal.
All right, yeah.
No,
party.
I didn't mean.
I didn't mean, yeah, party.
Touch my hand, Ryan.
Whoa. He's like, touch my hand, Ryan. But yeah, I'm going to have him touch his hand. Do it. Do it,
Ryan.
Bro.
Yes.
I just want to go on record and say that
the
this
group
is
impressed
bad
with Ryan.
Dude.
It's gonna be fine, man. Trust me. It's gonna be chill.
It's like these subtle nods that they're
all right,
saying.
All right. Hacketeers.
I'm like,
party planning committee.
I'm picking
Let's
up
do
what
this.
You're putting down.
Okay, first things first. Nick and Abby, you will get some firewood. Emma and I will go to the stores.
Back
for
to
some
the fun
supplies.
Music.
And Dylan, you just, I don't know, figure out how to charge the phones for something.
Figure out how to charge the phones. It's called just going inside, bro. Okay, I'm gonna pause really quickly Just like a minute break real quick, but I will be right back. Hello, 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 friendos. I am back. Thanks for waiting. Let's get right back into it. Left off from these crosshairs. I love this part. Just seeing them for the first time. You're just like, what the hell is happening? And fun fact, that's Carl! From Detroit, if you watch Detroit. And then, you know, Randy from Earl. Dude, he's covered. Who needs a hammer? And you could just use your knife. Hunting season. Here we go. That was the end of chapter one, I think? No. Yes. Maybe. Unclear. I guess I could have waited until we got to this, but I felt it would have been more fun.
I was hoping you'd come back
to just me. Come right back into that.
Let's see what you've found. Empty-handed.
Oh, I found nothing.
You need to look around you. Find my cards, and I can help you. Where I'm from, we look out for each other. Find them, please.
Okay. Hi, welcome to the stream. I just finished chapter one, and now we'll be moving on to chapter two.
You better be going. It's still early, and the moon is bright, but time won't wait. Not for those with a story to tell. Be careful. Look out for yourselves. And look out for my cards.
Yeah, okay, sure. Okay, here we go. Back into it. Truth age stuff.
So here we are, stranded, in the great American wild with nothing but our wits to guide us. Will humanity prevail, or will we grow ravenous and resort to eating the flesh of the deceased like I saw in that one plane crash movie?
That doesn't seem good.
First course, filet au Jacob. Rich and full-bodied, this rare beefcake.
Just zoom in.
Irritating taste lingering on the palate. An acquired taste, some would say. Wow.
What?
Looks like you're trying to thread a needle with a packet of loose sausages.
Oh my god, I'm almost done, okay?
She's really such a bitch.
And for the record, your analogies are very hurtful.
Yeah, see? He doesn't like
okay, I'm
it.
Almost there. One second.
I'm just gonna kick the door, because I'm gonna maintain her bitch Whoa. Status.
And scene.
Well, I mean, I could have kicked it.
You loosened it for me.
It's like, what was the point of picking a lock if you were just gonna break the door anyway?
Okay. So, if I were a beer, where would I be hiding? Beep, 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 beep.
What
beep,
are you doing?
Beep. Oh, it's my beardar.
Beardar.
Helps me dar for beers.
Huh. Cringe. How am I just noticing how super lame you are?
What?
Yeah.
But it's my beardar, dude.
I'm gonna go over here. Wow, the kids really wiped this place out. Mr. H loved his accessories.
Ooh, I found a safe.
Think it's locked.
Yeah, that's how safes work, bro.
Don't know what I was expecting.
Oh. Oh, hell yeah!
He just now notices, like, the huge pile of watermelons.
Check out my giant melons.
Of course.
See, you just cut a hole in it.
Mm-hmm.
You pour in your vodka. It's party time.
You pour the vodka right in it.
Yeah, it's the most fun you could have with a hole in a watermelon. Or, well, second most.
Okay, I'm gonna leave you two alone and go look for some more party supplies.
Going through this maze. Let's open this. Oh, harem scarum. That's definitely
harem
a theme.
Harem scarum?
It's like, who set up this maze back here? Oh, what are those, little raccoons? Oh, I wanted to look at the raccoon. Oh, Randy. Oh, that I cannot interact with. Okay. What am I supposed to be interacting with here? This one? Oh, yeah, I want to do this one.
Hello, old friends. Oh, yeah.
Let's scare Jacob.
Can't pass up an opportunity like this. Okay. Have y'all ever seen a grown man crap his pants? Because you're about to.
She's so awful. At least I'm making her be awful.
Oh my. Alright, now where should I hide?
Oh, I thought it was going to let me choose. Usually if they ask rhetorical questions, it has
Jacob.
Me choose.
Jacob!
Emma? Hello? Look, if you're trying to scare me, it's not going to work.
Is it, though? Yeah, no, that did not work at all.
No, they're
They're funny.
You think this is supposed to be funny?
Yeah, that looks a little bit more scary, I mean, for sure.
Yeah.
Well, do you think it's funny now, little boy? You want to join 20 of my sexy clown friends in a tiny car that somehow fits us all like it's no big deal?
It's just so weird.
What?
Moment's gone.
Like, she was just trying to, like, videotape him saying something dumb, I'm assuming. Like, yeah, that wasn't worth it. Oh, well. Am I going the wrong way? No, this is the right way.
Wonder where this goes. Locked.
I will kick door. Because I want to see her get hurt. Yeah.
Mother! Hubbard!
What you done to your foot there? That looks painful.
Shut up.
Done. Whoa!
Whoa.
Whoa.
The fucking mother load.
Good golly, Miss Molly. I wonder I kept this place locked up.
You think he'll be pissed when we made a stash?
What? No. I mean, he left us stranded here. It's like, human rights or whatever.
Sure. Yeah.
All right. Now let's see what we are working with. Hold that. The door will latch otherwise.
Okay. I don't know how he knows that, though.
Oh. Hell yeah. In and out. Job done. Boom.
I want to look around.
Go for it.
Let me find some clues, boy. Like, why not bring the ice cream? I definitely want ice cream. He's just like, nope, in and out, we're done. We don't need anything else, cool. Just beer.
What? What is it?
A gun.
Oh, cool.
With a 4-digit code on it. I wonder.
A code.
Does that have to do with the safe? Yeah, most likely. What, okay. Is she trying to be like Laura Croft or something?
So you're really gonna keep the gun, huh?
I mean, yeah. Like, yeah.
For bears.
Okay. Well, I am gonna find something to haul this lot back to camp.
What happens if you just don't take the gun? Like, I've never tried that. But I feel like that would be pretty interesting to see. Because it's like you'd get rid of all the combat situations, like at the beginning at least. At least I can take this way back. How did he beat me? Going through the maze.
All right.
Well,
I'm in.
Hey, very nice.
I was able to remember it, and I didn't have to, like, actually remember it myself.
What else is in there?
Just some fireworks.
Fireworks?
Ooh. Yeah, but I don't think we should.
No, Emma. Fireworks.
Yeah, I'll just take them. Because why
know,
not?
You're right. Fireworks.
Yeah, hell yeah! Fireworks. Oh, and might I just add, fireworks.
Fireworks? Jacob seems excited. Yeah. Who would have thought that?
Oh, stop. Stop. Stay right there. Oh, dude.
This song
peanut butter
right
butter
here.
Pops.
Who's ready for that?
Dude, peanut butter fucking butter pops.
What are those?
What are Butter Pops.
No.
What?
I can't believe it. Okay. Pop, pop, peanut butter, butter pops. Pop, pop, pop them in your mouth.
T-pose.
Pop. Oh, my God. They're like the greatest snack of all time.
What are they? Are they like popcorn?
What? No. No, 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 no. They're nothing like popcorn. They're like their own thing. Like their own subgenre of food snack. You know what? I haven't had
but
these.
But what? Like
since
peanut
I was
butter
a kid.
Flavor?
You are in
what?
For such a treat.
Okay, wait. Is there an expiration date on that bag?
No, they're still good.
Oh my God, they're like 20 years old, aren't
okay.
they?
Look, they predate expiration dates. Blah. Well, you're gonna love them.
Blah.
Oh
blah. Oh. She's still the worst.
Well, I saw a wheelbarrow out front, so we can load up all our booty in there.
Ooh, yeah.
I'm sorry, what?
Booty? Oh, it means like treasure or butts.
No, before that.
Wheelbarrow?
Yeah.
Okay.
What about it?
It's like a barrel with wheels.
He doesn't know that?
Put
like
stuff
she doesn't
in it
know
and
that?
Just wheel it around.
Oh, I see.
Ladies first.
Yeah. Which way?
Did they bring coffee in there? There's just like two coffee cups on the counter. Like, who went to Starbucks over here?
All right. The inner sanctum.
It's just an office.
This is where the magic happens.
Okay, yeah, let's just make this quick.
Sure, just give me a sec to get this going. And engage.
I just noticed, like,
podcasts.
What is that picture on the wall? Was it, like, an alive
yeah.
deer or not
right.
an alive deer? I couldn't tell. I'm gonna be friendly to him, because I kind of want them to be
the
a thing.
Listening to right now?
Bizarre yet bonafide.
So, like, ghosts and stuff?
It's like, yeah, like, the weird and the wonderful, digging up weird mysteries and discussing if they're, well... Bonafide.
Boner fied. Get it? Boner.
What a joke.
Your wit knows no
He's
bounds.
So good.
So, should we check out what Mr. H keeps in his private den of sin?
I don't know, man. I feel a little weird going through his stuff.
Yeah, it's a little
okay,
weird.
Okay, well, I don't. I mean, come on, what kind of dirty secrets is the owner of a summer camp full of impressionable young children gonna have anyway?
That sound effect right when he says that's like, oh, what
Not
kind
Mr.
of dirty
H,
secrets?
He's cool.
It's always been cool to me.
I just want the gun. Can I just go straight into Chris's room? Yeah, I want to do that.
Yo, my guy, toss me the keys.
So you can poke around in Chris's private area?
I'm sorry, is that something that only you're allowed to do?
Hardy har har.
Hardy
Come
har
on,
har.
What's the harm in looking? It's you're not a little bit curious.
His responses
I'm not
to some things are just like
fine. Don't let me regret
so
it.
So weird sometimes.
Can't promise that, but nothing but net.
You're using that wrong.
Oh.
He's just such a buzzkill sometimes. Like, he's just trying to be fun.
Huh. Fashion icon.
Mr. H knows what he likes.
Like, doesn't he wear the same
sure
thing
he does.
Every day? It's just a uniform.
Wow, there's... Yo.
Hey, hey, maybe we shouldn't...
Like, this right here is so confusing to me. Like, why does this
Brian?
Room even exist?
Whoa, what the fuck?
Like, who built this
These
house
monitors,
where they're like, I'm
the
gonna
camp.
Make that bedroom closet
is Mr. H
have the cameras
on us?
In it?
No, no. I mean, No, he can't be. These are just, they're all different trails.
Like, having security cameras isn't, like, that weird.
Sure.
So, but putting it in that closet is kind of weird. It's not like
he's spying on the kids, unless they wandered out into the woods.
Definitely makes it creepy.
These are just, probably just trail cameras.
What are trail cameras?
People set them up to catch weird, random shit.
Okay, yeah, like what?
Like, Bigfoot sightings, you know, that kind of thing.
Oh, yeah, Bigfoot sightings. So... Oh, yeah, maybe he listens to the podcast.
I didn't know Mr. H was into that kind of stuff. Shit, maybe he likes that podcast that you listen to.
Secret hobby, I guess.
Expensive
Secret
hobby.
Secret hobby.
Yeah, well, yeah. What else are you going to do out here?
Yeah, I guess camp probably does get pretty lonely when there's no one else around.
Yeah.
Okay, but why go through all the trouble of hiding this room
through a secret door
in the closet?
I mean, it's not exactly secret, right? Like, it's just hidden.
It's behind clothes, dude.
Stuff.
Yeah, that's what a secret is, Ryan. It's weird. It's majorly weird.
I don't disagree with you, but...
It's gotta be something juicy in here.
Dylan, it's none of our business. And if you really want to know, you can ask him tomorrow. I'm sure that won't be an awkward conversation, like, at all.
Okay, yeah, maybe I will.
All right. I'm leaving the secret lair. Have fun.
Hey, you just admitted that it's a secret lair.
I'm not going to really explore anything else other than this camera room, I think. Oh, and taking the gun. Well, no, they won't let me take the gun, I don't think. I feel like...
What was that?
Ooh, there we go. We got a little ghosty going on. Got the Hag of Hackett's Quarry. Did you not hear the podcast? Hag of Hackett's Quarry. Oh, can I take those, like, tools? Is that an option? Oh, it's just letters.
Huh.
Oh. It's Max and Laura's letters. Whoa. There we go. I, like, wanted to start the cutscene, but wasn't sure. Okay, we got some juice. That's it. That's all I'm going to look at. Let's not know it. Oh, just kidding. This is the bathroom.
Whoa, there's some pretty heavy-duty stuff in here.
Yeah, why would you look at someone's medicine cabinet?
Yeah, there's nothing fun.
I guess this way is the way back in? Yeah. Okay. I'm just... Okay, well, I guess our phones are ready.
Nice. Full up.
Full up? How is 28% full up? Let's just go to the party, man.
Hey, Dunzo.
Alright, cool. Let's go.
Thank you.
Aw, we have super sweet, fun times.
This would be a lot easier with Mr. H's chainsaw.
What?
It's really very pretty out here when there's no kids around.
Oh, the chainsaw to get wood. Okay, I forgot that they were trying to get firewood.
They always seem to listen to you during painting class.
Like, oh, it'd be a lot easier with the chainsaw. Like,
you've
what
seen
would
my class?
Just walking by.
The art cabin's all the way out of the way.
Yeah, well, there's this shortcut that I take you guys by.
You just would go by and watch the class all the time.
Which way should we go?
Why don't you choose?
Ooh. Doesn't immediately change to... Oh. Okay, now we got the music back.
Good
Let's
choice.
Go on the rocky road.
Better sticks this way.
Better sticks?
Yeah. Like burning or whatever.
Hi, welcome to the stream.
think we've got enough?
I'm only on chapter 2, but my plan here today is killing off everyone but Caitlin.
Not yet.
Probably won't get done today, but definitely in another stream. To learn some facts about the quarry itself. So I think left is the safe way and right's the dangerous way. So I'm just curious what happens the dangerous way. Just falling rocks, right? That's what the sign said. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, the music stopped. It's no longer cheery.
Shit.
Oh, it's God. All right. Calm down.
It's just some falling rocks. No one's gonna die, right? Aw, dang. I thought there was gonna be some dramatic cutscene. We just heard some rocks fall and that was it. I guess that was kind of a lame way. Oh well. I made it back to the regular path though.
So, you ever think about what's next?
Like, after we die? It's heavy, man.
No, I mean like...
I was clearly asking
future.
About after summer camp, dude.
Yeah. Sometimes. All the time. It's overwhelming.
I know what you mean. Sometimes I just try to, like, let it happen, you know?
What?
Like, whatever happens is what was meant to happen.
Like it's all predetermined. Fate.
Interesting. I'm gonna be uncertain.
I don't know. I'm not sure we're supposed to know.
Oh, that's deep,
yeah.
Man.
Fate just seems so convenient.
How so?
Because if it's all predetermined and you do something terrible, then you have the excuse of saying, well, it wasn't really me because everything's been pre-planned and then I'm not really in control of my actions, am I?
I never really thought about it like that before.
I don't think he was thinking of it like that. Yeah, exactly.
I mean, well, it's totally okay if you believe that.
Yeah,
way
no,
to backtrack
totally.
On what you yeah. just said just to, like... have a boy like you. Like, good job, Abby. This is like, Nick is definitely one of my least favorite characters, especially, like, playing as him, because you get this chapter, and it's just picking up sticks, literally. And
oh, I know
his
where
attempt
we are.
Attempt at flirting.
Here, hold these.
Sure.
View is just wow.
She just stops like mid conversation to start drawing. Like he has no idea what to do right now. He's just awkwardly staring at her. I'm gonna piss her off.
Ooh. Do me.
Oh,
Sorry, I'm just trying to get this down.
Right. Sorry. Dumb idea.
I just want to finish this.
Take your time.
It's totally trying to distract her. Dude, that's kind of rude, Abby. You're in the middle of a conversation. Not a very good conversation, but better be a pretty good drawing.
Did you hear that?
Huh? It's probably nothing.
No, listen. There's something there.
Aww.
Look!
It's so tiny.
My God, he's so cute.
Hold on. Hold on.
I'll save her, sure. Did I save her? All I did was push her. I'm just not gonna hold my breath. I don't know what happens.
Ah, this slime! Oh.
That's all that happens. He just gets slime.
Oh, no.
I'm gonna say, did you draw that?
Okay. Did you get all that?
Huh?
I thought you were gonna draw me getting French by a wild pig.
Ew, French.
Got it all up here.
It's a bit dramatic. Back to the heartwarming music. There's no heartwarming. I know how to say words. So, I'll grab my keys. Dude, there's no way that notebook fit in that backpack. That backpack is tiny. Like, it just kind of, like, appeared. And then it was gone. Disappeared, sorry. No, just kind of disappeared right into the backpack. Oh, yay, we're at the fire pit. We get to be Caitlin, finally. And all she does is pull out her phone.
Finally get my phone back, and it's just a big, dumb brick.
Oh, look, it's the treehouse. I'm gonna take a picture over by the treehouse and see if I can see anybody there. Oh yeah, I feel like the light was on in there.
Hey, Caitlin. Guess what? Mr. H is a voyeuristic creep. He has hidden cameras everywhere and a secret room.
No, that's not...
Whoa, now, back up. What?
His eyes are everywhere. He's always watching us.
Knock it off, man. He's just got trail cameras set up. You know, forest surveillance, that kind of thing.
Oh.
Yeah, that seems a lot more normal.
Well, he's got a perimeter to check, kids to protect. You know, probably just to keep track of wildlife.
You guys have no imagination.
So, what's going on here? Everything ready?
It's just more realistic. There's a weird light in the treehouse. Let's talk about
it. I did see a weird light in the treehouse across the lake. Yeah, that was pretty spooky. Maybe it's your girlfriend, Ryan.
Ooh.
The Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
I told you never to say Hag of Hackett's Quarry again.
What's wrong with saying Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
Oh my God, over and over again.
You know, I just realized we may never see each other again after tonight.
You can't have just realized that.
Just trying to set the mood.
What mood?
The mood, the vibe, you know.
Speaking of setting the mood, I have work to do. Okay, because playlists don't make themselves. I mean, I guess they do, but...
All right, Rye Guy, time to get wood.
Yikes. Wording.
Oh, I know what I said.
But
Abby,
like,
Nick,
wasn't that what Abby
time.
And Nick were doing? They were getting wood?
We got wood. We've already done that joke.
It's mostly just kindling.
Oh, that's all we need. There's already a big pile of logs here.
Oh, perfect.
We could have gotten more, but there was a hog or a boar. But Nick was very, very brave and took one for the team.
Oh, hell yeah. The hog of Hackett's Quarry.
Oh my gosh, it can't be. The hog of Hackett's Quarry?
What?
I thought you hated that phrase.
Big jokes take big sacrifices.
You're so brave.
Oh, yeah,
I just want to shrink you down to little pocket people and put you in my pocket and pee
the relationship between Caitlin and Ryan. Like, I really don't.
Okay.
That's so awkward.
Whoa. Ooh. Special delivery.
Like, see, Ryan just thinks I'm making fun of him when I was trying to be playful. And like,
where the hell did that gun come from?
Show him I would like something the way that he likes it.
Well, I mean, it's a real gun, but it's just for shooting bears.
We found it in the storage room.
Okay, fine. Fine, we'll put it down.
Thank you. Guns are no joke, dipshit.
And we bring you a hand-picked selection of only the finest that Hackett's Quarry has to offer.
No freaking way.
Yes, freaking way. Pop, pop, peanut butter, butter pops. Pop, pop, pop them in your mouth.
I love the dance
that
it does, though. It just makes it so much more.
I didn't even know you could still find these anywhere.
Hey,
awful.
Cool jets there, cowboy. All right,
I don't know what word you thought I was going to say, but it ended with awful.
Dude, you can't just shove those in my face and not expect me to want to pop, pop, pop them in my mouth. Come on.
Emma, please hand me the shotgun.
What, you going to shoot me over them?
No, dumbass. Okay, we
He's immediately backed away, like...
Shoot for them.
Nah, dude. Absolutely not. No.
I mean, yeah, I'm not leaving him with the gun.
I mean, there is no way I'm leaving you dillweeds alone with a gun.
Come on, look, the shooting range is like right over there, okay? It'll be fun. Okay, look, you and me, old-fashioned shootout. First prize, peanut butter butter pops, all to yourself.
Dude,
I guess you don't really want them then, huh?
Fine, you're on.
Yeah, boy!
I guess that's one way to do a competition.
Jacob, hand me that gun now. I mean, nobody's handling any firearms if you're gonna act like a dick about
it. Okay, then you can be the ref. We need an objective third party.
Okay, we're trying to get a party started here, Jacob.
Okay, well, the main party's not gonna die just because you're off on a little side quest. Come on. Please.
I mean, true.
All right.
Just a little side quest.
We're gonna have ourselves an old-fashioned shootout. Look, there's a clearing we can use as a shooting range back there, but... if I see either of you dicking around, I am turning this car around.
Oh,
we'll be good.
It's like, what did she just say? Like, don't dick around. And then just, like, punch someone. Like, yeah, that shows you can be safe around guns.
Okay, so, just so you know, I was an expert marksman. Third class, 3 years in a row. Ranked highest in camp each
really?
Year. I'm just letting you know... that your goose is cooked, Nick, but if you back down now, I might let you just have one little peanut butter butter pop if you're lucky.
No way. You've never even seen me shoot.
Yeah, that's because you've never shot before.
Yeah, not that you know of.
Yeah.
Okay, I think I would know if you'd actually...
Okay, boys, I'm going to have to stop you right there. As much as I'm enjoying your charming machismo, the moment we step foot on the shooting range, we're playing by my rules, okay? And what I say goes. Got it? Okay, good. Now I'm going to go set up some targets and get more shells. Do not move a muscle or touch his gun until I'm back.
All right, so is it just me? Is it kind of hot when she gets all bossy like that?
I'm always hot, pencil
deck. Yeah, okay, thank you. Bye. Bye.
I mean, she's just going to be setting everything up for them.
How's your little one-on-one with Abby in the woods?
I'm going to say, how things with Emma? Yeah. Not even answer the question.
How was your little one-on-one with Emma?
Oh, it's incredible. She's totally still into me.
That's really? What he got from this? She literally put on a clown mask to scare him.
Long distance thing.
Is that what she wants?
I want to know what she wants.
Well, I mean, you could ask her.
I mean, yeah, you could just ask her.
That's funny. Speaking of, let me show you how a real man shoots his gun.
Are you guys seriously still thumping your chests at each other?
No, I think he's got brain damage.
Okay, please just give me the gun.
You'll have it when I say you'll have it. All right, hold on, boys. This is how we're going to do this.
Actually, like, who put her in
charge? You're shooting the one on the left. Nick first, then Jacob's turn. Keep your fingers off the trigger till you're ready to shoot. You got it?
Aye, aye.
The one on the left, but, like, does that mean the bottle or the...
Remember the spread.
Watermelon.
Remember the recoil. This is a shotgun. We're not sharpshooting here. The flashlight shows you where you're aiming. Obvs.
There we go.
All right, Nick. 1 point. Okay, I mean, we're too far back to do any real damage. Let's scooch forward a little and fuck these guys up. You're good. All right, Nick. This time for real.
The one on the left, like, does she mean the bottle or the watermelon? That's what I'm confused about. Oh,
nice
I was supposed
shot.
To break the bottle. Yeah. Okay. Oh, the one on the left.
Lucky.
I mean, I don't know if I'd call that luck. I don't know if I can split it between the two of them.
Wait, do
yeah.
you, Nick?
No.
Good job, Nick. Alright.
It's definitely more fun aiming
Let's
for
see what
the
you got.
Bottles than the watermelon.
Alright, you might want to avert your eyes, Nick. I don't want to give you any more performance anxiety.
All right. Just shut up and shoot, Jacob.
Huh.
Yeah,
I thought you were an
ultra
elite pro marksman.
Yeah, with like a rifle.
Whoa,
okay,
dude,
not just
like
a
blaster.
That is how you get someone
dude.
Shot.
Yeah.
Nah, it's okay. You probably would have missed me anyway.
Hey.
Okay, disqualified for being a dumbass.
What? No.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, butter pops.
Ooh, what's that, Jakey? Huh? Huh? Pop. Pop. Peanut butter, butter
Okay,
pops.
I get it.
That was not the song that he sang to Emma, for sure.
Blam, you thought this was over?
What the? Whoa.
Pop, pop, peanut butter, butter pops.
There you go. Now we know the real winner. A little catch in the music. Finally, the full moon is out. It's truth or dare time. This will probably be like my last chapter. I'll probably end at the end of this chapter for this stream. Just because I think that'll be a good place to end. The end of the chapter, right? Wow, this is just a really long transition. We get it. Okay.
Okay. New idea. Party game.
Yeah, that party seems kind of lame.
Come on, people, we might never see each other after tonight. Let's make some memories.
Well, what do you have in mind?
How about the ultimate game of secrets and lies, truth or dare, but Dylan style? Okay, house rules are... Someone asks you truth or dare, then you choose, and then you do. And there's no ifs, ands, or buts.
So, like, normal truth or dare?
Yes.
I mean, yeah.
So we can, like, make people kiss?
If they choose dare, yeah. As long as everyone consents, of course.
Cool beans.
Cool beans.
I mean, keep it in your pants until it's your turn, but...
Well, who does get to go first?
Well, it's house deals, so... Abigail, truth or dare?
Truth.
Really dodged a bullet, huh? All
right. I could choose whether she said truth or dare.
Have you ever slept with anyone?
Oh, God, this is just awkward. She just sits there, like, super embarrassed. I'm gonna interrupt.
Hey, take it easy, man. That's too far.
Come on. I'm not finished.
Look at Jacob. He's just like...
Have you ever slept with anyone?
Dylan's annoyed by my interruption.
No. Nope. Sorry.
All right, Abby, it's your turn.
Make her not feel as awkward, dude.
All right, okay.
Abby, oh my god, just pick someone.
Okay.
Hi, welcome to the stream.
I don't know.
Ugh, ding, ding, ding. Too late. My turn. Ryan, truth or dare?
Like, you can't just choose a person? I gotta do dare every dare. Time. I don't think I've ever chosen truth. So, like,
okay,
I literally
Ryan.
Don't know what happens. If
your dare
truth.
Comes with a choice.
Can't you do that?
I can do whatever I want. And I dare you to kiss either Caitlin or Dylan.
Wow. I mean, I guess both is off the table.
Sorry. I don't make the rules.
Both you is off the table. Did,
but okay, let's do this.
He has to make a decision. Yeah, see, I usually go to Dylan for Dylan. Ryan. I feel like that's a
let's
better
go.
Match than Caitlin. Also, I'm trying to make Caitlin like the last girl, so or the final girl.
Always happy to please.
That was great. Look at that. Dylan's just like, I get to kiss my crush. That was fun. But then Caitlin's like, ugh. It's like no matter what you do, it's just like this
Alrighty,
weird love triangle.
Well, me and Jacob haven't gotten a turn yet.
Good point.
Let's do Caitlin.
Caitlin, what do you say? Truth or dare?
Truth. Yeah, truth.
Let's see.
What did
when
you want
you
to be
kid,
when you grew up?
What did you want to be when you grew up?
Fun fact,
kind of
I wanted to
question.
Own a garbage dump when I grew up. Like, when I was really, really young, I was like,
the answer
garbage
is,
dumps are just, like, so cool. Like,
that's
get
true.
All this cool
Sorry.
Stuff in there.
So,
I think it was, like, just from
true.
An episode of Arthur
nope.
where I was like, wow.
What?
I smell
that's
bullshit.
What I want to do. I want to own a garbage dump.
Okay, fine. You got me. I wanted to be a street performer.
See? That's a little
no
bit better.
Way.
Well, A street performer? You mean like...
No, asshole. Like a mime or, you know, one of those statue guys that move when you give them a dollar.
Caitlin is a mime? Yeah, no, I just can't imagine that.
That's weird.
Thanks, Ryan. Well played. Now it's my turn. Emma.
There.
Ooh, who is she gonna ask? Emma? Okay.
Emma, so you have to kiss Jacob or Nick.
Why does she give him a choice? This just makes it
well,
so
then.
Awful.
Sorry, Nick. This is not even there, obviously.
I don't know if that's a good idea.
I choose Nick.
Oh, God. Because she's just that much of a bitch. Like, I wanted to choose just so she couldn't fuck shit up. And yet,
M,
here we go.
Seriously?
She just wants to piss everyone off. Like, she's just a bitch. Why is Nick, like, into
nice.
It, though? Like...
Guys!
Like, Dylan and Ryan literally just went like, and then they were done. And then, like, these
Thank
guys,
you, Nick.
They're just, like, fucking making out. Like, so unnecessary. All because Emma's awful.
He's good.
Like, do you think that's something that your friend wanted to see? Like, you, like what an awful friend.
You're, like, kissing my girlfriend.
And girlfriend, or ex-girlfriend.
It was
but
just
no.
a game.
Hey, I'm nobody's girlfriend.
The fuck it was. It was just a game. Yeah, the fuck it was, man.
Okay, he does go a little over the top, but...
Jacob, grow up. Well, I guess I should probably go after him.
You think?
You should probably go find Abby.
Yeah, no shit.
So, anybody want to play Parcheesi? What?
It's pretty lame. Trying to like... Yeah, I don't think this party's ever gonna come back when it's just like the three of them left. Oh, this is how you know it's the end of the chapter.
Fuck this.
That's great. I love seeing, like, the actor who plays Carl in, like, such a completely different role.
Welcome back! I am, as always, delighted that you're here.
I am going to pause her.
So, then.
And, oh, great, we get to see just her lovely, lovely face. But, yeah, this is where we're going to end the stream. Just staring at her beautiful face. But yeah, thanks for joining, everybody. It's been fun. We're getting it through the first two chapters. They are done, which is awesome. And so then when we come back, we're going to start killing people, which is going to be fun. So chapters 3 and 4 is when they start to get interesting and you can start to kill characters. The first few, like this, the prologue, chapter 1 and 2, which is what I just finished. They're pretty standard, just setting up the scene, getting to know everybody. But yeah, now we'll be able to have some fun in the next stream. So thanks for watching. I plan on doing that actually Wednesday night. So I'm going to do that Wednesday at 6:30. That'll be Central time. So that is 4:30 Pacific time. But yeah, thanks for watching. So if you're want to see the rest of this, check my schedule. I'm also doing Until Dawn Tuesdays and Thursdays at 6:30. So similar games. It's just spooky season. But thanks for watching. I am ending the stream now.